Can we stop the ticking of the clock anyway? Could we stop the aging process altogether? Maybe we can. And look at this. Worn-out mitochondria waste energy. Up to 20% of all the energy from the food you eat is burnt in generators, the mitochondria, but the electricity is wasted. It just fizzes across the membrane. You give rats alpha-lipoic acid or acetyl-L-carnitine, and suddenly their mitochondria operate at nearly 100% efficiency. You have killed the aging process. You have stopped it. You restored them to maximum efficiency. That has an impact. It has an impact on the way rats run mazes. It has an impact on how they remember. It has an impact on their healing capacity. What about a medicine which does this? What about a medicine which you could take every day for a month and throw it away, which would lower your blood pressure to normal and give you a total body lift at the same time? Imagine walking down the street. You don't know whether a woman is 19 or 90. Actually, it's in clinical trials. Did you know that? The company is called Altion, but don't buy the shares. Why? Because it only works in mice and rats. They get a total body lift. What it does is it restores the elastin in the skin. It dissolves out the carbohydrate, the sugars, which map together elastin fibers as we get older. It dissolves them into the bloodstream where they get eaten up as fuel. As a result, not only the blood vessels start to stretch in the normal way, but so does the skin. Extraordinary. What would happen if we found a way to actually make it work in humans? What happens to blood pressure therapy then? A lot of pharma companies would be quite worried about that. What about monkeys? Monkeys, we are keeping mice and rats alive to the age of 170 in human terms. We're keeping dogs alive to the age of 140. We keep earthworms alive to the age, in human terms, of 200 years. And now we've started on monkeys. We know the story about restricting calories, but this is different. You can get many of the effects of restricting calories in animals by giving them metformin, which is a drug you use to treat diabetes in old people. If you give it to healthy people, they're fine. They don't get any side effects except a problem with alcohol. We just tell them not to drink alcohol, and they can take a drug for 20 cents a day, which perhaps will give them the same metabolic effect as starving them. It's very interesting. What it does is it clips off the peak of sugar level after you eat a meal. After 20 years, we don't know what the result will be because we haven't been following for longer than 20 years, but after 20 years, in some studies, 80% of the monkeys are alive versus only 50% on normal calories. They have less cancer, less diabetes, less heart disease, less strokes. And then, of course, there's the stem cell story. We know how to repair the brains of mice and rats that have had strokes. We have animals running around their cages after transecting their spinal cords. We know that your own brain can repair itself. It does so every day using bone marrow stem cells. How do we know that? Because put your hands up if you knew that. I'm sure you've heard the story about the man with the woman with the male brain. Woman with leukemia, irradiated, and cured. Cured by a bone marrow transplant from a wonderful, wonderful match. From a male donor. When she died, she gave her body to medical research, and they did all kinds of things. And as someone had the wild thought of actually inspecting the cellular structure of her brain. And they discovered her brain was full of XY chromosomes. And male cells had seeded her brain with new viable tissue from her bone marrow. And had clearly been doing so every hour of every day that she had lived. We're not quite sure what the exact function of those brain cells are, whether they contributed to consciousness or whether they're just supportive structures, but we're learning all kinds of things about the regenerative nature of brain tissue, and that's made us think again about the power of stem cells. And then, of course, we start combining them, as we've already heard today, with polymer structures of various kinds, and we start to see other extraordinary possibilities, not just growing tracheas, but all kinds of other organs as well. Fascinating. And what about the non-aging whale? I'm really interested about another invention I'm going to show you, which allows us to read the genetic code of human beings at high speed. We know that there's some kind of whales which don't get old. There's no sign of aging in them whatsoever. You follow this by looking at the Rockfish Project, which is an American project. I think that some of that team will win Nobel Prizes for aging. Why? because rockfish divide into two types. Some of them are dead in 20 years and some live to the age of 100. We have no idea why. The ones that live till they're 200, they die of stuff, like infections and things, but they don't get old. Every one of you has seen a doctor in the last 2 years, but if you have, it will have been because of your birth certificate. Almost certainly because of something that is related directly to your age. But not these ones. The whales too, some of these humpback whales live to the age of 200, the rest are dead in 20 years. We know it's a gene trick. It's a gene trick that must be the same probably in the rockfish as in the whale. We are unable to find a single mechanism of physiological aging in these creatures. Soon we will know what those gene differences are. And all genes do are make proteins, and we'll know what the proteins are too. Which will enable us perhaps to activate a similar gene inside a human being. By the way, parrots and turtles probably have the same gene, if you think about it.